Greetings gamers, FiOth here, and in this video I'm gonna show you, or rather explain, how you can implement DLSS up to 3.1 at this point in Resident Evil 4 Remake and make your experience extremely smooth, much more efficient, and see some graphical improvements in the process. Now, what I'm doing here is running the game all settings maxed, no ray tracing because that's bugged and crashes the game all the time, 2K, and as you can see I'm getting almost 120 locked frames here, 99% utilization of the GPU. I am running 8GB VRAM preset on my textures, although I'm running a 3070 Ti, which is an 8GB VRAM card. So instead of just showing you all the links on screen, I'll have them all listed in the description where you can go and get each one of the components. I did not invent or program this. I learned of it from a channel called MX Benchmark PC, and I will also list the guy's vid. He did a service to humanity with the way he compiled all this information. So what we're doing here, we are basically modifying the files of the game. This is not an executable, so if you think that you're gonna get a file, install it and run DLSS, no guys, it's not how it's done, but in the description I'll have all the information you need. We will basically be adding some more components to the main folder of the game, and when you start the game you will see a window initializing. I'm gonna demonstrate said window later on in this vid. It will take a moment, you might think that the game is stuck, but it's not. When the window initializes, it will present all its options to you, and you can modify according to what you wanna use. If you're asking what preset we're using here, it's the quality preset, and I don't know if you can see this in this vid, I will upload this in 2K, but there will be YouTube compression. It is impressive to say the least, and the performance is stellar. The downgrade is that you'll get a little bit of shimmer on shiny surfaces, one, and two, sometimes the on-screen HUD, for example when you change your weapons, will be a little bit blurry. Since this is not an implementation done natively by the company, of course there are gonna be a couple downsides, but it's a very small price to pay for what you're getting here. Huge boost to performance, much crispier graphics, and an overall amazing experience. So I'm gonna demonstrate the window that I mentioned now. There will be a hotkey assigned. You can pick whatever hotkey you want. You can also click on remember settings right here as you see it. And on temporal upscale, you choose what kind of upscale you wanna have, quality, performance and all that. It also fixes the ultra wide aspect ratio if you wanna play like this. So that's an added benefit. Hope you found this useful, guys. I'm covering everything in Resident Evil Remake, so sub, like, share, hit the notification bell for more content and streams. Until next time, be well, stay frosty, and always strive for perfection. Cheers!